Biographical Review. Abu Muhammad Ali ibn Ahmad ibn Sa'id ibn Hazm Al Andalusy, or more commonly known by the name of Ibn Hazm, recognized as a scholar who has tremendous contributions in the Islamic world. He was recognized as a jurist and hadith as well as theology, historian, poet, statesman, academic experts and politicians reliable. No less than 400, the title of the book he has written. Preface of the author. In the name of God the Merciful, the Compassionate. Thus spoke Abu Muhammad, may God forgive him. There can be no better beginning for my book than to praise Almighty God as he is worthy, and to pray for his blessings upon Muhammad, his servant and messenger in particular, and all his prophets in general. And then, may God keep us and you in perplexity, and not burden us with more than we can bear. May he of his kind help give us a guide to lead us to the obedience of his will, and may he grant us of his help some means that will take us away from all the crimes against his commandments. Let us not give ourselves to our own weak and feeble powers, the fragility of our physical frame and the confusion of our opinions, our bad choice, our small discretion, the corruption of our passions. Your letter came from the city of Almeria to my abode in the court of Jadava, where you told me a happy news of your well-being. I thanked God for this and I begged him to follow it. Prosperity. From then on, for a while, and I saw you in person, because you searched for me in spite of the distance, the vast separation of our dwellings from one another, the distance from the place of visit, the great space to be crossed, and the terror of the journey, and there were other obstacles that might well have deflected the heart more anxious, and distracted the most resolute memory, except a man, signed as you in the chain of loyalty, respecting those old quotas and deeply rooted affections, the rights of passion and the camaraderie of youth, a true lover with God. Such is the attachment that God has established among us, and for this we praise him and give him thanks. In the mentioned letter you expressed ideas that exceeded what you were accustomed to find in your other communications. Then, on arrival, he clearly revealed his intention, and informed me of his views with that frankness that has always characterized our relationships, that habit of sharing with me all his sweetness and bitterness, all his private thoughts and his public profession. In this you were guided by the true affection, which I give doubly reciprocity, desiring no other reward but to receive the same return. It was on this subject that I composed the following verses in a long poem addressed to Ubaydullah ibn Abd al-Rahman ibn al-Muyra, great-grandson of the Caliph al-Nasr, may God have mercy on him. My own. 1. Essence of love. My love for you, which is eternal by its own essence, has reached its apogee, and can neither wane nor grow. It has no cause or motive other than the will to love. God forbid that no one else knows him. When we see that a thing has its cause in itself, it enjoys an existence that is never extinguished. But if it has something different, it will cease when the cause on which it depends ceases. In it you will see all opposites remaining. And so how can you define contradictory concepts? O body devoid of dimensions! O accident lasting and not ceasing! You have broken down for us the foundations of theology, which, since its appearance, has ceased to be clear. O my hope! I delight in the torment that I suffer for you. As long as I live, I will not depart from you. If someone says to me, you will forget your love, I answer no more than with the end and O. 2. Firm, on the signs of love. My eyes do not stop, but where you are. You must have the properties that say of the magnet. I take you where you go and as you move, as in grammar the attribute follows the name. When I leave your side, my passions are like those of the prisoner whom they bring to the torture. As I go to you, I run like the moon filling you through the confines of the sky. But, starting from you, I do it with the morosity with which the high, fixed stars move. When my eyes see someone dressed in red, my heart breaks and rips with grief. It is that she with her eyes wound and bleed men and I think the dress is soaked and soaked with it blood. Pastor I am of stars, as if I had to charge all the fixed stars and planets. The stars in the night are the symbol of the fires of love burning in the darkness of my mind. It seems that I am the guardian of this dark green garden of the firmament, whose high grasses are embroidered with daffodils. If Ptolemy lived, he would recognize that I am the most learned of men in spying the course of the stars. I stayed with her alone, with no more third than the wine, while the wing of the night darkness opened smoothly. She was a girl without whose neighborhood she would lose her life. Woe to you! Is this desire to live a sin? I, she, the glass, the white wine and the darkness, we looked like earth, rain, pearl, gold and jet. Until the night came I waited to see you, O my desire, O my wish. But the darkness made me lose hope, when before, even if the night appeared, I did not despair that the day would continue. I have for this a proof that cannot lie, for many analogues guide us in difficult matters, and is that if you had decided to visit me, there would have been no darkness, and the light, your light, would have been incessant among us. Beautiful patience is imprisoned, but the tears flow freely. Ah! The eye that, on the day of Wasit, does not shed for you how many tears remain, is that it is of stone. Yazid ibn Umar ibn Ubayrawi, the man who, when you abandoned him, does not lose his best resignation for you, is that it is of ice. An indication of grief is the fire that burns the heart and the tears that spill and run down the cheeks. Although the lover celebrates the secret of his breast, the tears of his eyes publish it and declare it. When the eyelids let their springs flow, it is that in the heart there is a painful torment of love. I distrust you even in the most despicable thing that you do, and to whom it is necessary to despise as who despises these things, without seeing that they can be origin of rupture or of hate. The fire in its beginnings is a spark. Everything great begins by being tiny. From a small bone you cannot see the tree born. 3. From who falls in love with dreams. I would like to know who he was and how he came at night. Was it the face of the sun or was it the moon? Was it an idea that reason illuminated in his reflections? Was it a spiritual image that brought thought to me? Was it a specter wrought with the hopes of the soul and which the vision had the illusion of attaining? Perhaps it was nothing of that, but a disgrace that fate brought me as the cause of my death. 4. Of, upon whom fall in love for hearing of the beloved. Oh, you reproach me because I love whom my eyes have not seen. You exceeded the painting as very prone to falling in love, because tell me, does anyone know paradise is not because they talk about him? The troops of love have camped in my ears, as the tears in my eyes show. They made me your painting, but when I saw what they were painting, I realized that it was pure delirium. The drums of the drum frighten and startle the man, being more than an empty danger. They told me about you, and when we met, my idea came true before my eyes. The paintings of paradise always remain short and point to what is, truly, paradise. You exchanged our affection and disgust and intense hatred, just as the pages of books are altered as they are copied. Referring to Ab-Mir, having treated him won me as a brother and made me find a precious treasure. I used to hate being close to him, and I did not want him to be my friend. I was detested and now I want it, from odious to pleasant. I ran away from him for a long time, and now I am constantly at his side. 5. From who falls in love with a single glance. My eyes sinned, stirring this anguish of love in my heart, and my heart sent tears to avenge my eyes. How to find just these reprisals of crying, when they flood the pupils with their fluid torrents? Before I saw her I never met her to meet her, and the moment I saw her was our last encounter. 6. Who does not fall in love but with the long treatment? I have shook off the calls of love, for I believe that upright men will cut through the sound, and I have seen that there is a trace of love in your eyes among the flowers of your cheeks, for you are happy and calm, and suddenly you see yourself in chains, as one who, deceived by the little depth of a current, loses foot and disappears in the rising tide. True love is not born in an hour, nor does your flint give fire whenever you want, but is born and spreads slowly, after long rapport, which strengthens it. Then there can be no abandonment or waning near him, nor can steadfastness and increase go away. It confirms this that we see that all that is formed soon also perishes shortly. I am a hard and stony land, reluctant and insubordinate to all vegetation, but if some plants have their roots, they do not have to be careful that spring rains abound. He swear that he intends to love too, as manes lied in his principles. There is no place in the heart for two loved ones, nor what follows the first is always second. Just as the reason is one, and knows no other creator than the one, the merciful, one is also the heart, and you do not love that one, be far or near. Whoever is not, is a suspect in the law of love and is distant from true faith. Religion is only one, the straight, and the one who has two religions is unfaithful. 7. Of, upon whom, having loved a certain quality, can no longer love any other contrary. There was a young man whose beloved had a short neck, as if the girland neck were ghosts in his eyes, and was very much paid for the merit of his choice, citing a test whose truth is very clear. Wild cows walk in sayings to talk about beauty, and no one has ever denied them beauty. Well, they have a short neck, and not a single one is graceful. And are the camels beautiful with their long necks? Another had his beloved whose mouth was torn, and said, "My model in point to mouth are the gazelles." And there was a third whose lover was low, and said, "Highs are like monsters. They shave her because she has blonde hair, and I tell them, that's her beauty, I think. They err, who vituperate the color of light and gold, by a foolish opinion, altogether false. Will somebody censor the color of the fragrant daffodil, or the color of stars that shine in the distance? Only the creatures of God, farthest from all sciences, reject the black, coal-colored bodies. Black is the color of the inhabitants of hell, black the dress of those who mourn for lost a son and are in mourning, and since the black flags appeared, the souls of the men who do not carry orthodoxy are safe. 8. From, on verbal illusions. A young man, as beautiful as a gazelle, a pair of the moon full of the sun, when he was making his way through the clouds, captivated my heart with his languid glances and his branch-like figure in its slenderness. I humbled myself as the docile lover humbles himself. I submitted to him as he submits the madly in love. But come to me, my love, in a lawful way, because I do not like union through forbidden paths. When I heard about this lance, I said, reproaches and complaints of injustice came from who was both an offender, a judge and a litigant. He complained about what he felt, and nobody, except the one who complained, knew what he meant. 9. From, on signs made with eyes. To the verbal illusions, once the acceptance and the mutual concert have come, the signs made with the eyes happen, that play in this respect a laudable paper and they yield wonderful effects. With his eyes he turns away and attracts himself, he promises himself and he threatens, he rebukes himself and he gives himself encouragement, he orders and seals himself, he fills the servants, he forgets the spies, he laughs and cries, he asks himself and he asks himself. Response, conceives and refuses. Each of these situations has a special sign in the gaze, but these signs cannot be defined, of not seeing them, nor can they be painted or described but in very small part. I am only going to declare those things that are easier. A sign with the corner of one eye denotes a veto of the thing requested. A languid look is proof of acceptance. The persistence of gaze is an indication of grief and sadness. The glance is a sign of joy. Squinting makes it seem threatening. To return the pupil to any part and remove it to the point is to draw attention to what has been looked at. The furtive sign with the corner of the two eyes denotes supplication. Moving the pupil quickly from the center of the eye to the inner commissure indicates impossibility. Moving both pupils from the center of the eyes is absolute prohibition. The others cannot be understood except by seeing them. 10. On correspondence. It is hard for me today to break your letter. But, on the other hand, love does not break it, and love is better when the ink is erased, for the accessory must be sacrificed to the main thing. In how many letters is the death of the one who writes them, without his knowing when they were drawn by his fingers? I have received the answer to the letter I sent you, which has calmed my excitement and, at the same time, excited my calmness. I repressed it with the tears of my eyes when I wrote it, as does the lover who is not a traitor to his love. Weeping did not stop erasing their lines. Oh, weeping, how much beauty you have erased! My tears mixed with the ink made visible the first line, and the last line was faded by tears. 11. From On the Messenger. Your messenger is like a sword on your right hand. Take a good look at its edge, and do not strike with it before you sharpen it. For the evil that produces a harsh sword turns against him who, unknowingly, wields it. I know two lovers who used as messenger a trained pigeon, on whose wings they attached the letters. On this subject I have said in a poem, Noah chose her, and did not deceive the hopes that he put in her, because she brought him good news. I will also entrust you the letters I write you. Look, then, letters go on the feathers of a bird. 12. From On Keeping the Secret. Those who do not know what love is, they censure me because I love you, but, in my opinion, it gives me the one who insults you as the one who is silent. They say to me, you have set aside all disguise, even though you showed zealous people observant of religious law. I tell you, to hide my love would be pure hypocrisy, and one like me detests the hypocrites. When did Muhammad forbid love? Does his unlawfulness consist in the clear revealed text? As long as I do not commit forbidden things, by which the day of resurrection resounds with the perplexed face, I ignore, in matters of love, what the censors say, and, for my life, it is not for me to speak out loud or in a low voice. Is man responsible for something he has not chosen freely? Will he who is silent be rebuked by the words which he did not utter? Judging by the torments of sickness that are seen in him, if he lives, it is because death has compassion on him. The tears of the lover spill, the lover's reputation is hurt. When the beloved appears, his heart beats like a catafalque in the net. Say, my friends, for your opinion is of common certainty, how long will I conceal this, that I cannot let go? I have for the secret so hidden a place, that if he enters into it alive, there can be no doubt about his death. I kill him there. But that death is the life of the secret, just as sadness is the joy of the lover. 13. On Disclosure of Secret. Serious matters do not treat them in jest, but if you want something easy, do not waste your energy. When the vicissitudes of destiny assail you and the attacks of fortune are frequent, prudently oppose the right effort. Little will suffice against little, much against much. Cannot you see the candle? Freshly lighted, when it begins to shine, it blows out a breath. But, when they catch fire and flame, your very breath revives and propagates it. 14. From On Submission. Will the union times come back for us? Will the lapse of this lock have a limit? The sword has become a maid of the stick. The captive gazelle has become a lion. When you reproach me, I am the vilest of those condemned to death. The false coin that rejects the hand of the money changer. But besides, I find pleasure in dying for your love. How marvelous that of a condemned to death who rejoices! If the Persians had seen the fire on your cheeks, they would have passed without emperors or wizards. You have come to me with a face that pleases Acer Carsi, who sighed anger to go. My condition does not displease you to make me a few reproaches, even if the gray hairs are censored. Man, in his inner self, sometimes reproaches himself, and blackheads and moles dot the face. But it is if they are few, because when they are too many spoil it. Who will praise the excess? Help him, because he is grieved, he cries, being both paper, ink and writing. It is not reprehensible to bow down before whom we love, for in love the proudest humbles himself. Do not marvel that I submit myself to my situation, for before I submit it to the messenger, the beloved is not our equal, so that when you endure, your endurance is vile. If an apple falls on your head and hurts you, who then tear it apart, will it be a revenge worthy of fame? Take advantage of the opportunity, because you have to know that chances happen faster than lightning. How many things I was doing I left for later, and then, once gone, they became knots in my throat. Hurry up to get the treasure you found. He holds the prey like the hawk on the prowl. 15. Firm, on the contradiction, when I make my soul reach its desires of that gazelle that never ceases to torment me, it will both give me its aversion and its submission, and its anger will be the same to me as its contentment. When I find water, I must extinguish the burning of the tamarind coals. 16. Of, on him that casteth faults, the most pleasing to me are reproaches and criticisms, to hear in this way the name of one whose only mention is my hope. It is as if with the censorship I drank pure wine the name of my owner was the frustrate that accompanies him. 17. Firm, about close friend. Such a friend will comfort the lover in his afflictions, he will keep him company in the retirement of his misfortune, and associate himself in his intimacies. In it the greatest lover of rest must be found. But where to find it? Zakonseed was to lay their hands on you, tighten them on it as a tiller wraps, hold with them as the miser your money, and keep it even at the expense of all your property, because with it makes perfect the joy, are frightened away, if shorten the time, improve the circumstances, and no one will fail to obtain from those who meet these conditions an excellent help and a wise opinion. 18. Firm, on the spy. It makes me long visits and is the most demanding Tertullian. He makes conversations whose topics do not interest me. The mountains of Amamem, Radwa, Lukem, Yabul, Lebanon, Amamem and Hazn are less heavy. I have a fixed companion, who, purposely, never leaves. How sad this company is! As he does not leave us, he and we have come to be as the name and the thing named. They put a guard who did not leave my owner in peace, with the intent of separating me. But my continued kindness ended him, and one day the fear I had was changed into confidence. It was like a drawn sword to pierce me, and became a friend whose favor has no limit. It was a deadly arrow and it came to life. It was poison and it became triaca. My master has a spy who keeps him from me and who is faithful to who gave the order and does not betray him. All those around me have been put to spies, but the Lord of the Throne has also distinguished me with a third. Two young men were ardently in love with it, and each one was either trying to separate his rival. They resembled the stable dog, who does not eat hay and does not let him eat any other. 19. Firm, on the slanderer. Who will trust women, if he is not an imbecile, ignorant, bound by the ropes of perdition? How many came to a black puddle of death and drank from it attracted by a delightful white bait? I marvel at a slanderer who always walks behind our secret, and who breathes only to know our news. What does he care about my anguish or my anguish? I eat the grenade and the children give them teeth. Do not give credit to words you have heard, until you are sure that what you know is true, like the one who, at the birth of a mirage, spills the water that leads to death in the immense and barren desert. Do not mix the serious with the jest, because it would be like introducing between what is to save the soul the corruption of a medicine. He who has for his most effective weapon to carry false stories like the bustard, which defends itself with its excrement. I give to the target that I propose with such skill, that, if it were known, Waras would not aspire to primacy among the archers. How hidden you have come to light, both because I have been told as a situation that made me see your ugly character clear. How many times some things are clarified by others, as pregnancy, in law, confirms fornication. 20. Firm, on the love union, someone asked me my age, seeing gray hairs on my temples and my cheeks. I replied, I only know that I have lived a moment of reasoning justly and reasonably. How is that? He told me. Clarify it. You told me the strangest of the news. I said, to the one who has my heart, I gave a kiss one day, by surprise. For many years I live, I will not think that I have lived, in fact, more than that moment. I spoke at night with the full moon when my beloved was late, and I saw in her light as a glimpse of the splendor of my beloved. I spent the night happily, while love lied, the union smiled and the diversion frowned. I implored her with supplications that if I had addressed them to my lord, I would have been absolved, and if I had addressed them to the desert lions, they would have stopped hurting anyone. At last, after his departure, he allowed me to kiss him and excited my anguish that was still. I am like one who drinks water to quench his thirst, and suffocates himself by drinking, he falls into the grave. I exhale love from me as the breath, and give the reins of the soul to my enamored eyes. I have an owner who does not cease to run away, but that, at times and suddenly, he feels generous. I kissed him wanting to relieve myself, but the dryness of my heart only grew. They are my entrails like a dry grass where someone threw a burning blight. Go in the wrong time, pearl of China. I am satisfied with my ruby from Spain. When it sifts when walking, it looks like a narcissus bouquet that sways in the garden. It would be said that his tendrils are in the heart of his lover, because, when he walks, they affect the puncture and tinkling. He has the walking of the dove, in which the slowness is not blameworthy or vituperable. I would crave my heart with a knife, get inside it, and then close my bosom again, that you might be in it, and not dwell in another, until the day of resurrection and judgment, so that you might live in it during my life and, at my death, you would occupy the interlacings of my heart in the darkness of the tomb. How should I censor the estrangement and treat it unjustly, if the character of the one I love is all estrangement? Love would have been enough to put me in a bind. How, then, am I being reunited in my estrangement and love? Mixing the true with the false, or whatever I want in the eyes of the careless, although between one and another thing there are differences, whose sign is shown to the intelligent. It is like gold, alloyed with silver among the ignorant young men, but if it meets a right-handed goldsmith, it distinguishes you from what is pure from what is altered. One of the wonders of time, which overwhelms the hearer and the one who tells them, is that the mount wishes the rider, that the question submit to whoever asks, that the captive rule the apprehender, that the dead attack the killer. Before now we never heard among the people that what was expected would humble itself before the one who waits. Can you explain it otherwise by the submission of the passive participle to the asset? The clandestine union occupies a place that does not reach the possible and manifest union. It is a mixed pleasure of caution like walking through the dunes. The garden laughs while the clouds cry, as the beloved when the afflicted lover sees it. How many rounds did I turn around love, to fall into it, like the butterfly in the light? The promptings of love lead to union as the night traveler is guided by the glow of fire. I give myself to drink the second time of the union of my owner, as it is given to drink second time to the anxious thirsty. When you contemplate it, you will not be able to stop your eyes at a limit, because its beauty is always increasing and inexhaustible. 21. Firm, on the break. How many people I treat well, not because I am pleased, they stop me from pleasing, but for a determined intention. The affection that I show them is erected to another, like the grains that are put in the trap to hunt birds. The creatures of God that you see are all different. You drink the good, if you are not given the best. Do not be content with the muddy water rather than the force, when there is no watering on the earth. But do not go near brackish water, because it is not swallowed, and a free man should prefer thirst. From what your beloved gives you, take what you have done, and be happy, but do not be distressed by the one who is hard, because you cannot demand anything from him, nor do you have power over him, nor is it, if you look in trouble, your father or your mother. Do not despair of anything that can be achieved by cunning, even if it is hidden, because everything is remote and difficult. Do not trust the darkness, for then the dawn comes, nor deceive yourself with the light, because the sun also sets. Be steadfast, for the water pierced by the rock is forced to fall upon it. Go on and do not faint, and have a lot of little, because the drizzle is not abundant and yet quiet. If a man takes little by little, a poison ends up feeding him by giving him a proven nutrition. He makes haste to cross the road and strays to cut the bonds of love. But we are already getting heavy both mending his love, because while we mend it again tearing it. Stop deliberately breaking the bonds of love and tighten the bonds of our union, O unjust. Then you must return to strength, whether you like it or not, to what the learned sage said. After the reprimand, you will surely be as generous as you were before, and even more so. How many serene days dawn to their end make us hear thunders. But then the good weather returns to be as before, and you also hope that you return. I also reproach your little brother with words that he only hears. But if the darkness covers the sun, what is there to think about the new moon? Do not expect anything of the fickle. With the inconstant cannot be counted. Leave the love of the inconstant, it is alone that must be repaid. I turn away from the one I love, and not out of hatred. Marvel at a lover who is leaving. But my eyes cannot see the face of the traitorous gazelle. Death is of sweeter taste than a love that offers itself to the one who goes and the one who comes. In the heart there is a burning fire. Marvel how the restless lover suffers. God allowed in his religion that the captive would simulate apostasy before the conqueror, and declared a bid to infidelity in danger of death. So, sometimes, the believer seems to be an infidel. He had to ask fortune for one thing, which was in conjunction with the distant planet Jupiter. La Fortuna, kindly, push her close to my sight. But then he took her away from me, and it was as if it had not appeared or appeared before my eyes. So much was my hope that I lifted the Manapara to take it, but then it veered and fled to the Milky Way. When I was sure, I was frustrated. What was already achieved fled farther than Sirius. He was envied, and I envied him, was longed for, and I longed. This is how fortune works in her comings and goings. Therefore the wise man must not trust her. I have the misfortune to love a person who, if he saved his life, would say, I wish I were in the tomb. It is not my fault if I take my beast with water, my luck ruins the return. What is the fault of the morning sun that the weak eyes cannot look at it? How ugly the break after union, and how beautiful the union after the break. This is like being rich after being poor, that, like being poor after being rich. Your character usually has two phases, and my fortune with you has now two aspects. You are like Numan in ancient times, for Numan had 2 days, the day of delights, which was the happiness of man, and the day of disgrace and enmity. Only the day of your favors is for others, and my day with you is only of affliction and rupture. Is not the love that I have for you worthy to be rewarded by treating him well? O you in whom all the beauties are lined up, as the pearls are threaded on the necklace, why does death come from you to hurt me, if it is your face of happiness? Is it the time when I say goodbye to you, or is it the hour of judgment? Is it the night I walk away from you, or is it the night of the resurrection? Is your rupture the punishment of the Muslim who dies and hopes to find God later, or is the eternal torment of the infidels? God bless the days and nights that passed. A fragrant water lily appeared to us as it unfolded, whose white leaves were the beautiful and splendid days, and whose black center was the night that shortens life. In them we had fun with society and friendship. They came without us noticing, and they left the same. And they have followed a time that seems, not to doubt, the betrayal that happens to the beautiful covenant of love. Do not despair, soul, that perhaps our time will return a favorable and not adverse face, just as Clement brought the kingdom back to the Umayyads. Refuse in the meantime in resignation and patience. 22. Firm, on loyalty, the works of men tell us of their nature. Knowing the essence of a thing relieves you from following the trail. Have you ever seen that the oleander gives grapes, or that the bees acquire a cyper in their honeycombs? No merit has to keep a secret to those who keep it, but keep it to whom he himself publishes it. It is like splendid generosity, which is more sonodic when the gift is rare or the donor is greedy. Take me as if it were the rod of Moses, and bring them all, even if they are the serpents among the lotuses that wave their tongues. When I am not doing many prodigies, the presence of the lion is less pronounced when he is lying down. They expect what they will not get, as the Arfidis expect absurd from their imam. If all hearts and souls had my firmness, their languid looks would not make them stick. My soul rejects by necessity the vile term, as the genitive ruling particles reject the verb. My judgment furrows all that is hidden, as the veins throb in the body. I clearly distinguish even the face of the ants, while they hide the shelters of the elephants. 23. Firm, on betrayal. A little loyalty is esteemed in the beloved, and nothing is worth much loyalty in the lover. The rare start of a coward is more than the exploits of him who is always brave and determined. I sent a messenger after my desires, foolishly trusting him, and he has distanced us. He loosened the bonds of my love and secured those of his own, taking away from me what was possible. I have remained as a witness after being the one who required them, and he has remained a guest after having been mine. 24. Firm, on separation. I see his house at all times and times, but whoever lives in it is hidden from me. And what good is it to me to be near the house? Is there a spy that is waiting for my visit to its inhabitants? Oh my! I hear the noise of the neighbor, and yet I know that China is closer to me. I am like the thirsty man who sees the water in the pool and has no way to get it out. Absent is my beloved, like the one on the tumbler who does not separate you except the slab that covers it. When will this soul afflicted by passion heal, and the house to whose dwellers cover the remoteness draw near? I know a hind, neighbor of our house, and India is closer than this hind for whom she seeks. But in spite of everything, the neighborhood is a relief. The thirsty is comforted when he approaches the Guish, waiting for you on the world-known paths. Go, the sword is but a wait until it leaves the sheath. This disease, whose cure defies the physician, will undoubtedly lead me to the gully of death. But I am content to fall victim to his love, as one who drinks unlearned poison in a generous wine. What else does destiny want? What little shame she has, and with what eagerness she tends to take possession of every soul in love. My fate is like an Umayyad who believed that I helped the S against Ottoman. I think that you are a return of paradise, that God grants that of his friends who is a pious ascetic, so that I may chill with seeing the yearning for my love, whose ardor is that of a bonfire of tamarind. Marvel at some accidents that appear, with no individual to support them. The spinning firmament is to me like the ring of a sword a jack all girds in which you are the precious stone. Your beauty and beauty do not need comparisons, as the sun of the heavens does not need jewels. I am astonished at how my soul has not perished by its absence, its drowsiness being my grave and its loss the presage of my death, and how my delicate and fragile body has not melted the rough hand. You have lengthened the time of separation, and when the time of absence ceased, and we were near, you again separated. Your closeness was but a blink of an eye, you have returned to my distance, my anguish returned to me. Thus a stranger in the shadows, when he has lost his way, sees a lightning flash in the darkness of the black night, but the illusion that at last fades away soon. Certain hopes are not useful or profitable. My eyes have been refreshed by your closeness, as much as they burned in the days that blinded you the distance. May God be patient and resigned to the past. May God grant and praise you for what you now decide. I wish that whoever is outside the earth should be inside, and that whoever is inside should be outside, that I should have died before this calamity that has come to leave in my bowels embers of fire, that my blood had washed his corpse and that the ribs of my bosom were his tomb. The good news came when despair reigned, and my heart was in the seven terrible floors of hell, and I clothed my bowels with green hope, after having been dressed in mourning. The blackness of grief fell away from me, as the shadows recede in the sunlight. All this, although I do not expect another union that does not speak of firm loyalty to the old affection, that sometimes the cloud is desired, not by the rain, but by the fresh shadow that unfolds. Its beauty can supply the flowers, as my breath can supply the fire. The flowers fall before his face, perfect face, where nothing is left or lacking, warm, when the morning sun is in Capricorn, fresh and pleasant, when the sun is in Leo. By my life I do not despise the day of farewell, even if I break the union of my spirit with my body, for in him I embraced whom I love without worry, and before, when I asked, I was not generous. Is not it marvelous, in spite of his tears, that the day of union envies the one of departure? You gave me a love that you used to deny before, and you gave it to me with full hands. But at that moment I no longer needed him, when, before giving it to me, I would have reached the interlacings of the heart. Medicine is of no use when it is to death, and, instead, it is useful to give a remedy before the agony. Now that the separation has come, you give Gina Roses a hidden love that you used to show yourself miserly. This is what you do is redouble my anguish. Why, woe is me, did not you do it before? When the fortune was welcoming, you gave me deviations, and today fortune deviates, you give me good welcome. You prefer me when your preference does not suit me anymore. Why did not you do the same thing before, when you were withdrawn? In every separation that occurred, hope is lost. Do not be in a hurry to be discouraged. Anyone who does not die does not walk away. But when one dies, despair is firm. It is perfect and white as the sun when it appears. The other maidens are not at their side but stars. His love has made my heart fly from its place, and, after a moment's rest, it is still fluttering. It seems now that I never delighted with your words, of such a magical spell on hearts, and that I never got my desires, when I did not pay attention to them so much to please them. I was shown detours as friends, they swore to abandon me and they were perjurers. Stop the two of them and ask the ruins where their former inhabitants are. Is it that the day and the night, when passing over them, have consumed them? Everything is erased, abandoned, naked. It would seem that the dwellings have disappeared and concepts have been taken. They advise me, go and you will forget and you will end up wanting oblivion. I tell you, I will die before I die. Who will drink poison as an experience? Her love captivated my soul, and her remoteness made her perish. Love is like my guest and my soul is his sustenance. A lover, in the interest of his love, adopted the separation, but it is not of our kind that he flees from those he loves, for he works like a rich man who made poor life and who, for fear of poverty, suffered beforehand. Do you worry because it sounded the time of partery? You grieve because you have to harness the camels? In truth, it is tremendous your misfortune and hard to have to separate yourself from those you love. Those who say that yet mortal feed themselves of rupture lie. They do not know what it is the yearning begins to load the bales. The separation is the death, when it arrives. If it makes us thirsty now, it gave us plenty of time to drink. If it grieves us for it, for a long time we rejoiced. I wish I were back today to see the crow. Perhaps he would remove your distancing from me. So I said, but the night he dropped his veil, swearing that he would not finish, and he did it. The star was astonished on the celestial horizon. He did not walk or, because of his perplexity, he moved. You would think he was someone who had gone the wrong way, or a timid, embarrassed, or threatened suspect, or an exhausted lover. 25. On compliance. If you refuse to join me, know that I am happy to look at you, since there is no union. I only have to see you once a day, even if I was not content with double. Thus, the ambition of the governor usually stings very high, but when the dismissal comes, he is content to save his life. Here I dissemble and I pay for the return of the greeting, if, sometimes, it is possible. If there is no way to get your love, if I cannot get closer, make a promise, even if you do not comply. Perhaps the illusion of meeting with you retains the life in my heart afflicted by your detour. Those who complain of drought will be comforted when a lightning flashes in the sky, even if it does not bring rain. They say to me, the one you love has been hurt. And I reply, by my life, you have not hurt me. It is that my blood has felt its urge and it has jumped towards him, without being able to contain itself. Oh, you who favor me in killing me with injustice. I would like to be your ransom, a beneficent tyrant. When I cannot be near my owner, when he insists on avoiding me and is not fair to me, I am content to see his clothes or some of the things he has touched. So it happened to Jacob, the righteous prophet, when he was sad for Joseph, he smelled a robe that was from him, and being blind he was cured by her. I believe that her saliva is water that gives life, although she, with her love, has not left me guts. Blessed is the land that you dwell in, blessed are those in it, because happiness has settled in it. Its stones are pearls, roses, their thistles, its waters, honey, its dust, amber gray. The ghost visited a young man whose love was tenacious, in spite of vigilantes and guardians. I spent my joyful and joyful night. The pleasure of night vision made me forget to be awake. As soon as I fell asleep, the vision of Num came to my bed, when the night rained and the shadow spread. I thought it was underground, but came as before. We took to being united and returned our time to what was before, and still the return is better. To what was once, and still the return is better. For you I am jealous until I meet my gaze, and I fear that even the touch of my hand will dissolve. For keeping me from this, I avoid meeting you and I intend to join you while I sleep. Thus, my spirit, if it is a dream, is with you, separated from the body members, hidden and hidden, because, to unite with you, the union of souls a thousand times better than the union of bodies. I saw in our dreams that we were leaving and we were starting to say goodbye in tears. But when I awoke, I found you holding me, and my sadness, upon seeing you, has dissipated. I then renew the embrace and pressed you against me, as if I came back to you from a heartbreaking separation. The specter revolves around the longing lover who, if it were not for the ghost's visit, would not sleep. Do not be astonished that it is oriented in the gloomy night, its light drives away the darkness on earth. They have been emptied of inhabitants, as if they were the dwellings of the D, to whom the Temdi succeeded. I see you have a broad sleeve in accepting what happens, and the best thing you can do is be soft and indulgent. The part you have is some of the best, because your possession is reduced to the tooth. A quarter of a camel weighs twice as much as you can think of in a kid. Pay no heed to whoever reproaches you. The game you love with two swords is wonderful. So follow the same path that he follows. 26. Firm, on the disease. The doctor, who knows nothing, says to me, heal you, O you who are sick. But my illness no one knows but the Lord powerful, the exalted King. How can I conceal it if the sobs, which do not leave me, and the walking always downcast, and the traces of sadness in my face, and my body exhausted and wan as a specter. Things are all the more clear when the signs are obvious. That's why I say to him, explain a little, then, for God's sake, you do not know what you're saying. He replies, I see you thinner every day. The disease of which you complain is consummation. I say, consummation affects the limbs, and it is a fever that has alternatives. But I, for the life of God, do not complain of fever, and I have little warmth in my body. He says to me, I observe that you are startled and lurking, thoughtful and always silent. I think it's melancholy. Look at you, it's a nuisance. I say, your reasoning is absurd. What do you say about the tears that flow from my eyes? He stood head down and in one piece with what he saw. How can a clever man not be astonished at this? I tell him, my illness comes from what I would remedy. Are not intelligences lost to this? And the proof of what I say is palmaria. The branches of a plant, if reversed, become roots, and against the poison of the vipers there is no more triac to guarantee the cure of the stings than that poison itself. You stole the heart by force, and who can live without heart? Help him with the union so that you live nobly and reach the prize on the day of judgment. For I see that if this lasts it will change the ankles of his ankles by the chains of the madman. In truth, you have fallen in love with the sun, and your love for you is evident to humanity. 27. Firm, on forgetting. If you look, the one who is alive dies by his gaze. If you speak, you would say that the stones are softened. It is love as a guest who made high in my spirit. My flesh is his food, my blood, your drink. He is patient to endure the poverty to which the glory must follow, even if the clouds fire on him. But he is impatient with the consolations that give him a dark life, for sometimes well-being is a torment. Let me insult my beloved, for, though I may seem disdainful, I am not an enemy. My insults to the beloved are like that which is said, kill him God and how well he has done it. He who forgets those he loves is not like the one who consoles himself to lose them. It is not equal to give up of industry that cannot. He who rules his soul is not like that which yields to him. He who is naturally patient is not like that who strives to be. Work as though I had never known you, that I too will act as if you had not known me or loved me. Being like the echo, which responds to what is said, if you want something today, think well before. O wonderful time when you were dearer to me than my soul and my family. But the hand of disdain did not let us until his fingers folded like a sealed scroll. I disdain your disdain so much to acquire as my love escaped me your union. I see that loving union is the true basis of passion and that long disdain is the root of forgetfulness. If they had told me before, you will forget who you love, 1,000 times he would have sworn, that will never happen. But since after long disdain is that forgetfulness come, blessed be your disdain, he is fatigued to heal me. Now I marvel at oblivion, as I once marveled at the firmness, and I see your love already like a brazzask fire, but under the ashes. I shudder for a sun, which, when it is set, has the darkness of the cabinets by sunset, a sun incarnate in this maiden, figured as a white roll of parchment. It is not human but of lineage. He is not a genius but an appearance. His face is a pearl, his body, a jasmine, amber your breath, all of it, light. so slow walks between his garments, as if he stepped on eggs or the edge of glass knobs. Do not censure her because she flees and refuses to join. How is it possible to label it for that? Is there a half moon that is not far away? Is there a gazelle that is not elusive? You neglected my beautiful face in my eyes, and you were with me avaricious of your words. I see that you have made a merciful vow of silence, and that you will not speak to any living today. But you have sung verses of Al Abbas congratulations, Al Abbas congratulations. To find Abbas, I would take falls between eyes and fall in love with you. He cries for a deceased person who died very honored, when the living would merit more tears. It is marvelous that he should be saddened by those who went down to the grave and are not for whom he is unjustly murdered. Your love, to which I must not draw near, is fallacious. You serve as a bed to everyone who comes. You are not content with a single lover, and you have a great crowd around you. If I were a prince, this prince would not pretend to be, for fear of the crowd. You are like desires, which, however many they may be, accept all who come to them and refuse to come to anyone, even if the trumpet has summoned the whole human race. Leave that, seize the time, saddle the gardens of the hills with the wine mounts, and toss them with exquisite lute melodies so that they will be excited to hear the flute. Better than standing next to the old dwellings, stop your fingers on the ropes. The unparalleled daffodil resembles a lover who languidly looks and tilts like a drunk. Its color is that of the one lover. Not to doubt, he is in love with a lily. I have two properties that have made me taste very bitter drinks, which have disturbed my life and destroyed my firmness. Each one of them wants to drag me to their side. I am like a prey from which they throw a wolf and a lion. One is loyalty to every test. I never separated from the beloved, who ceased to be eternally sad for him. The other is self-love, in whose yard cannot stop the offense, although I had a hard time sacrificing property in children. 28. From, on death. If I die of love, I will die a martyr, and if you give me your favor, I will live happily. Thus we have been told by sincere people, free from suspicion and imposture. I would like to know if the bond of your love remains intact for me, without weariness, and it seems to me that one day I will be able to see your face and speak with you alone in Baiti Muid. If desire could move the houses, the Baiti would come to see you as asking for help. If hearts could walk, mine would come to you with forced marches. Treat me as you like, because I love you and I have no other conversation than to talk about you. Even if you forget it, I keep a covenant made with you that is not broken. Even if you conceal the hollow of the tomb, I cannot hide my love for you. I went to your house, moved by nostalgia, after time rolled and passed over us, and finding it deserted and empty, my eyes have shed bitter tears for you. 29. From, on the ugliness of sin, she is a virgin whom the merciful made light, and whose beauty surpasses all estimation. If the day of judgment and sonar of the trumpet made a figure so beautiful, it would be the happiest of all the servants of God in paradise and in the treatment of the virgin's houris. Do not make your soul follow the passion, and stop exposing yourself to the dangers. Alive is the devil, he is not dead, and the eye is the door of temptation. To the one who opposes me, this thought is lost more and more, I reply. Stop censorship. Is not the devil alive? O you who do the honor of your legitimate women with which to hunt gazelle hatchlings, I see that the net is broken and that it will not be achieved, but the vileness of being empty. His friends who were here in the city came for music, but for fornication. They got their try, and you're an asshole of imbecility and foolishness. There is no doubt that you are the most candid man in the world, and the one with the best faith, intention and conscience. But get upset, because some of those who were making us talk were ugly things. He warns that not every prostration is prayer and does not see all who have eyes in the face. You came to me when the half moon came out in the sky, just before the bells rang, like the eyebrow of an old man, almost covered by gray hair, or like the delicate curve of the sole of the foot. And then the bow of God shone on the horizon, clothed with all colors, like the feather of the peacocks, with all colors, like the feather of the peacocks, with all colors, like the feather of the peacocks, with all colors, like the feather of the peacocks, with all colors, like the feather of the peacocks, with all colors, like the feather of the peacocks, with all colors, like the feather of